All right, greetings to you all that have joined us live for this Pesach of Yisrael. We gathered here in Teshua community. We're going to ask our Zion in the remaining to come and to bless this great Moad as we began the celebration of dancing and singing, rejoicing in the covenant that Yah has granted unto Yisrael. Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
At this time, we're going to ask that Op Shimri will come up and light the menorah for us.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, this is a beautiful day that Yahweh has made Israel. We must Zakah remember. Hallelujah. Let us remember what Yahweh has done for us, Israel. Hallelujah.
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 The lighting of the menorah, Rochem. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now at this time, Israel, we're going to ask that Teshua, Kol Israel, Teshua will come up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let us come up.
That's all right.
Surely,
Hallelujah.
Can we sing?
Oh,
on our side from the beginning of all things, Israel.
His Mishnah, his Torah was for Israel. We do Barak Yahweh for that. At this time, we do ask that Re'ah, Yahweh, Israel, will come up, Israel. Hallelujah. Israel, we gather here for this solemn feast, this beautiful time. As we began this process, what a great honor that God grants unto us to join ourselves unto the body of Yeshua HaMashiach. I know that we have this certain order today, but I said to my Zachin, I want to read an article that I wrote on the week past concerning communion, its meaning, what it implies, and the words that Joshua spoke as he gathered there with his Talmudim, as they knew his time was near. So if you would cause your ears to be attentive, I want to read this article. It's not that long, but I think it's vitally important for me to read it so that you may understand Israel. I began this article as we enter the season of this year, waiting for Yahweh's Pesach that is upon us. It brings about all kinds of interpretations and definitions of the previous events. There is words association to this event. Depending on one's upbringing of teaching, they have been accustomed to. Let us examine the word communion and what the word implies. When we hear the word communion, what does it generate in your thought process, or what it means and defines? Has your actions associated with the event defined what it means? If we examine the word closely, as we will see that what we thought it means, it is far from what it implies. The definition, according to Merriam-Webster, implies communion is an action or situation involving sharing, process in common unity, a function performed jointly, an interrelation in activities, an interdependent working together or cooperation, the fellowship of members of the same purpose and same desire. A state marked by fellowship. A state marked by fellowship, also of companionship, also of communication and understanding. It is intimate, reverent, that it reveres. It is one of caring and concern, also on mystic interchange of ideas and feelings, especially dealing with matters intimate and spiritual, in order to inspire, to strengthen, or to have solace. Often it is, if between a man and the nature of the supernatural. And I quote as that meaning defines what communion is. And also the religious aspect, that's my injection, the religious aspect, from the mother of all wickedness, wicked spiritual order, the church, what one defines as the church. And I define that any church is birthed from this whore. If one identifies as church or incorporated with what we call the church, it is the birth of this Eucharistic type of mentality that is not of Yah, which is Roman Catholicism. It says what that implies, or what communion is, from Roman Catholicism, it is the Eucharist, or the Lord's Supper, either as a separate service or as part of a large service, and that what we see in the liturgy of the Roman Catholics and also of any kind of orthodoxy of religion. But that is not what communion is, according to what it defines, the fellowship, the unity, the purpose, and that's what this gathering is all about. When we examine the nature of the meaning of what communion represents, it is far removed from the events meaning we'll celebrate associating it with the true events of Pesach of Yah and Yahshua. So I imply that what we will see concerning the Pesach of Yah, it has nothing to do with the true events as to what Pesach truly defines unto Yisrael. The true communion of Yahshua is not represented in the activities of the events that will be performed in many of the religious houses of spiritualism in the days to come. The true communion of Yahshua is a fellowship of Yisrael in the Tikvah, waiting patiently on the promises of Yah in Yahshua for all Yisrael. That we will remember the great offering of Yahshua HaMashiach. It is a gathering of great intimacy and love, of great love of Yah in Yahshua HaMashiach. In the fellowship of communion, we gather to the reassurance of ourselves and the words expressed by Shaul according to the instructions of Yahshua in 1 Corinthians 11:26. For as often as Yahshua said, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, do show Yahshua's death until he returns. What Yahshua wanted the disciples to remember when he made that statement, what he wanted them to remember is the great offering that he would offer for Yisrael. As the event went on the night before his death, HaMashiach commemorated Pesach and with his disciples, as it is laid out in the events, 1 Corinthians 11:24, when Yahshua had given Todah, he broke into bread and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, this do in remembrance of me. As the Pesach meal unfolds, Yahshua profoundly spoke in this manner. He said, this bread is my body, Luke 22:19. And he took the matzah and said, break, and broke it and gave it to them, said, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Also, Yahshua implies, this cup is the renewed breath in my dam and my blood, Luke 22:20. Likewise, also the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the breath hadassah in my dam, which is shed for you. HaMashiach was not instituting the service that many of us have grown accustomed to, as we see in the Eucharist of the Roman Catholic courthouse, the religious order. He did not establish that Yisrael, but he did. All we have grown accustomed to it, regardless of what it is called, the Eucharist of the Lord's Supper, of what is known as the communion that is done in these courthouses. As the Pesach proceeds, Yahshua spoke these words as they fellowship to comply with what Yah commanded Yisrael to keep the Pesach. What this meal was about, Yahshua was telling his disciples that during this season, the time of Pesach, that we, when we are celebrating and dancing and gathering ourselves together, we come to the veil of Yah. He says, do keep in our living, our land, and mind that I am a part of this. That's what it is. He wants us to know that I am here. This is the gift of the bread that we should eat tonight, but I'm here in the bosom of Israel. The formality of religious order, but that's not what it implies. That's why he says when you come together, do remember me. Don't ever forget me. Your body was broken, and God was shed for you. That's what he said when you come together.
As women say, just don't forget me. So that's what this is about. Don't forget the Lord.
That's what it's all about, he said.
said, don't forget me. That's why he said, take this bread and eat it.
Hallelujah.
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 So he said, don't forget me when you come together. Don't forget what I have done.
Just
hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so that's what it's about to be here. We break this bread tonight.
Yeah. He is to remember him.
And what he has done, not some sacrilegious type of religious order. It is a time of remembering him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He says, keep in your lap and your mind that I am a part of this event. That's what he was saying. He wants us to know he is here and he's a part of this. He says, do not forget my place in the midst of the fellowship. That's what communion is.
Hallelujah.
He doesn't want us to forget him. He wants us to enjoy his fellowship. This is all that he was implying in this matter. He did not create what is called the Eucharist or the Lord's Supper. Or Yahshua was saying, do not forget me in this beautiful act. Don't forget me. Yahshua is the vital part and the focus of Pesach. It is recorded in the Torah from the institution of Pesach by Yah to Moshe, where he read Leviticus 23:4-8. That the Pesach meal was an important aspect of the celebration of Pesach. Yahshua was keeping in line with what had been done from the beginning of Pesach. That is all that they were celebrating at the gathering of the Last Supper. Not instituting a form of religious activities known as the Eucharist that pretends to be in accordance with what Yahshua told his disciples. We keep the traditional construct of the meal that includes some wine, some unleavened bread, and the bitter herbs and lamb. As it is stated in the Torah in Leviticus, Vayera, and in Shema, Exodus 12, and Vayera 23. The Pesach is commanded of instructions to all that are Yisrael in Yahshua. We are commanded to remember the season of Yah throughout all our generations of the seed of Yisrael. Wow, you did you go my spelling, my Achyamin? I misspelled both of those. I didn't put the E on V, and instead of Yisrael, I put O-S. That's all right. Hallelujah. We can see the Torah of Yahshua. We can see in the Torah of Yahshua that he kept the Pesach before his death with his disciples as well. Shaul was one that observed the feast of Pesach as well. Lucas 22 and verse 8. Yahshua said, Kafan Yacharan, and go prepare us the Pesach that we may eat. Is this not an instruction of command to honor the Pesach of Yah that Moshe and all the Novi, the Navi did as well? Shaul instructs us here how we must keep the Pesach of Yah in Yahshua. 1 Corinthians 5:7, he tells us to purge out therefore the old chametz or the leaven, that you may be a new lump, as you are unleavened. For even HaMashiach, our Pesach, he has been zabach, offered sacrifice for us. Therefore, let us keep the Moed, the feast of Yah, not with the old Hamas or the old leaven, neither with the Hamas or the leaven of malice, wickedness, but with the unleavened malice or the unleavened matzah, the bread of sincerity and truth, according to all that the Torah commands. The Pesach has always been observed and practiced by the true Zerah, the seed of Yisrael, elect people of Yah in Yahshua throughout their generation. What we see today is the corrupt input of the wicked spirit of the religious harlotry of Christianity, concept that is being practiced among the seed of Yisrael today. We must denounce this with all of Yahweh's might in the truth of Yahshua. You are the true seed
of Yah in Yahshua will always comply to the instructions of the Torah commands as to how we will observe the Pesach of Yah. And this just information, what we will do, we'll observe the Pesach meal here in Teshuva community began in April 5th at 6 p.m. We'll gather to celebrate the great victory that God has given us in Yahshua HaMashiach. That is why we will always remember Yahshua HaMashiach on this great feast of celebration. We will dance, sing, eat, celebrate the true Torah celebration of Pesach and Yahshua by remembering Him. You join us in this great occasion, the Pesach, on the live broadcast stream beginning on April 5th at 6 p.m. To join us in this event, just click on here. And it says, Yabarak Kul Yisraya in Yahshua's name, Reach David Yisraya and Kul Teshua community. So I wanted to give us a definitive of what the community is, those that have joined us on the live broadcast. I wanted to, as I requested of our Zaki to do so. So it's my time to read the testimony of Yahshua, or the testimony of Yahkahan concerning Yahshua. We'll begin here at our booklet. You that have joined us, you can download this on the live or on our website, and you can join us and read along with us as we proceed. It says here the testimony of Yahkahan concerning Yahshua. I will begin reading here in Yahkahan chapter 1, verse 29. It says, the next day Yahkahan sees Yahshua coming to him, and he said, Behold, the Lamb of Yah which take away the sins of the world. Yahshua's dam, his blood, cleansed Yisra'iah from all sins. Sha'ul encouraged Yisra'iah how to keep the Mo'ed of Yah. 1 Corinthians, Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. He command us to purge out therefore the old leaven, that you may be a new lump. As you are unleavened, for even HaMashiach, our Pesach, is Zabach for us.
Yes.
Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven there, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Yahshua HaMashiach the High Kohan unto Yisra'iah the necessity of his superior dignity, the power of his office as the High Kohan to offer the ultimate offering, Zabach, for Yisra'iah to redeem us. It is stated here in the book of Ibram, Hebrews 9:23. It was therefore necessary that the pattern of things and the heavenly things should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves with better zebach than these. For HaMashiach is not entered into the Kadosh place made with hand, which is a copy of the true one, but into the Shema'am itself, now to appear in the presence of Yah for us. For he does not need to offer himself often as the Kohan HaGadol into the Kodesh HaKodeshim every year with dam that is not his own. For then he would have to suffer offering from the foundation of the Olam. But now once in the end of the world, he has appeared to put away sin by the Zabach of himself. As it is appointed to men once to die, but after the mishpat, the judgment of Yah, so HaMashiach was once offered to bear the sins of many, and to those that look for him, he shall appear the second time for our salvation, this time not to carry our sins. The redemption of the power of Almighty Yah by the dawn of Yahshua, which is expressed in 1 Kepha, 1 Peter 1, beginning at verse 18 through verse 23. For as much as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold, and from your vain conversation received by tradition from your avat, but with the precious dam of HaMashiach, as a lamb without blemish and without spot. was foreordained before the foundation of the Olam, but was manifest in these last times for you. Who through him believed in Yah, who raised him from the dead and gave him chavut, so that your emuna and tikva are in Almighty Yahweh. Since you have cleansed your nefesh in obeying the imat to the ruach in sincere Yisraelite akha, kindness, ahava one another fervently with a clean heart, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of the incorruptible seed, by the word of Yah, which lives and abides forever. Hallelujah.
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 We just told Abba Yahweh for that greeting, Israel. Once again, those that are listening by video live stream, we are joined here at Teshua Community, observing the feast, Peshach of Almighty Yahweh. And we are experiencing a thunderstorm, but as Rayak said at the beginning, if anything goes out in Israel, there will be a recording for you all that are listening by via to observe. Hallelujah. Let us continue, Israel.
Yes.
Hallelujah. As we observe the feast days of Almighty Yahweh and Yahshua, based on these instructions to Yisrael. Yeah. And before I begin in the book of Yisrael, I do want to just back up a little bit, because there was a few scriptures I did observe at the beginning, hallelujah, that I do want to read. Hallelujah. And it says here that we celebrate the feast according to the instruction of Almighty Yahweh. We begin the celebrations and the close of the celebrations in his appointed times based on this instruction, Shema 12 and 17. It says, and you shall observe the feast of unleavened bread, for on this very day, yeah. And that caught my attention, Yisrael, not 4,000 or 5,000 years ago,
yes.
Or whatever time period you want to place, but the Torah says this day.
Yes.
This is a living mishpah unto Almighty Yahweh, unto Yisrael. So this day, it is this day that we have Teshua in Yahshua.
Yes.
It is this day that the dam of Yahshua has cleansed us. This day. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He says, for in this very day have I brought your armies. Have I brought you forth, Israel? Mm-hmm. Can you imagine the thousands, hallelujah,
yes.
Marching on feet out of Mizraim? It can't be explained as an army. No, they did not come out with the armaments to defend their flesh.
Yes.
But they only had the Torah, which was spoken by Moshe from Almighty Yahweh. That's what they had, Israel.
Yeah.
Therefore shall you observe this day in your generations by ordinance forever. This day. It is alive this day, Israel. Hallelujah. The Torah of Yahweh is alive. So it's not something that we gather as a just a passing fancy, Israel. There are those that have their reenactments.
Yes.
They have their rituals. But as Rayah explained to us, it's for us to remember that day,
yes.
This day. Hallelujah. The deliverance of Almighty Yahweh. Verse 18, Shema 12. And in the first month of the 14th day of the month, at this evening, where we are at this time, Israel, he says, you shall eat unleavened bread until the 1 and 12th day,
yes.
Of the month at evening. Hallelujah. So it's this day, Israel. Yeah,
it
is. So let's begin back in Shema, Exodus 12 and verse 1.
Beautiful.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So to Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
And Yahweh spoke to Moshe and Aharon in the land of Mizraim, Egypt, saying, this month, Chodesh Abib, shall be for you the beginning,
yes.
Of months.
Yes.
It shall be in the first month, Chodesh Abib, of the year unto you, Israel. Speak you to all the congregation of Israel, saying, in the 10th day of this month, they shall take to them every man a lamb. Yeshua. Hallelujah. Do we have that lamb, Israel? Yeah. Yeah. Everyone, have we taken the lamb, Yahshua, yeah, HaMashiach? Yeah. According to the house of the Avah, a lamb per household. Now at this time, they had to take a lamb, whether it was of the sheepfold or of the goat.
Yes.
Can you imagine how many that would have took out of those flocks, Israel?
Yes, yes.
The meat, the blood that it took. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Do we receive this same advent at this time, Israel? Let me read on how we get to that. Hallelujah. Yes. And of the household that is too small for the lamb, let him and his neighbor next to his bayet take according to the number of the nephesh, or the souls of the brethren.
Yeah.
Every man according to his needs, you shall take an account for of the lamb.
Yeah.
Your lamb shall be without blemish, a male of the first year. You shall take it out of the sheep or out of the goats. And you shall keep it upon until the 14th day of the same month.
Mm-hmm.
And the whole assembly, the congregation, the bayah of Yisrael, should kill it.
Yeah.
In the evening. Was not Yahshua HaMashiach?
Yes.
Was not that offering, that precious offering in the evening time? Hallelujah. And they shall take the dom, the blood, and strike it.
Oh yes.
Strike it. Why strike it, Yisrael? He didn't say paint it. It was specific. Strike it. He didn't say rub it on there. He said to strike. When you strike, there's a force that you use on an object or a person or a thing. You use a brute force to strike Yisrael. That is very important. Was not Yahshua stricken amongst man, Yisrael?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Did he not feel the pains and the agony of the beating on that stake, Yisrael?
Yes.
So it says here, you should strike it on the two posts and on the upper doorposts of the house. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And in verse 8, and they shall eat of the flesh in that night, roasted with fire, and unleavened bread with the bitter herbs, and they shall eat it.
Yes.
He said, eat it, eat not of it raw or boiled at all with water, but roast it with fire.
Sure.
His head with his legs and with the inside or the inward parts. And you shall let nothing of it remain until the morning, and that which remains of it until the morning, you shall burn it with fire.
That's what he said.
And this shall you eat it with your loins girdled. Our loins girdled, Israel.
Yeah.
Our inward parts held fast, tight. Hallelujah. Nothing loose, Israel. And you shall eat it in haste. Why? Because it is Yahweh's Pesach. This is Yahweh's Pesach. It's not what we have offered unto him, but it's what he has given unto Israel. Hallelujah. Yahweh's Pesach. For I will pass through the land of Mizraim this night, and I will smite all the firstborn of the land of Mizraim, both the sons of man and also beasts. Yahweh was not playing. Hallelujah. There are those that want to admit this part of the Torah, because it seems a little disgusting and a little harsh, does it not?
Yeah.
But yet they justify their acts.
Yes.
Our acts have been disgusting.
Yeah.
They have been harsh towards Almighty Yahweh.
Yeah.
Yet the world, they can do anything. They can bomb nations, send a nuclear attacks, their armament, and they justify it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yahweh does not need anyone to justify him. He is justified by his own self. He is Yahweh. He is.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Man and beast, and against all the gods of Mizraim, he says, will I execute judgment?
Sure.
I am Yahweh.
Yes, he is.
Verse 13. And the dom shall be to you for a token.
Mm-hmm.
A token. How many of you just throw money away?
Mm-hmm.
Even the change. Are there not tokens, Yisrael?
Mm-hmm.
Why should we not hold fast to this token that has been given unto us, Yisrael? It's a great price, more than even money or wealth.
Yes.
And the dom shall be to you a token upon the house where you are. And when I see the dawn, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. When I smite the land of Mizraim.
Yes.
We know that true salvation and deliverance has been always by the dawn, the Peshat Lam.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For Yisrael. But this night, we know that Yahshua was offered only once for all Israel. Was it not Israel? So it is not for us to grab a lamb or a goat to cut the throat for the blood and to strike it on the doorpost.
No.
But this has already been done by Yahshua, HaMashiach, Yahweh's Yeshua. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He was smitten, he was beaten, he was stricken, and yet the blood flowed.
Yes.
And it was pleasing. It was a sweet smelling savor unto Almighty Yahweh, Yahweh's Peshach. Verse 14. And this day shall be to you a memorial, a zikrah, to remember a remembrance, and you shall keep the feast to Yahweh.
Sure.
To Yahweh. Mm-hmm. Throughout your generations.
Yeah.
And you shall keep it a feast by an ordinance forever.
Yes.
Only the Peshach in the history of Israel, is only one time, hallelujah, that it talks about the dawn, Israel.
Yes, yes.
And the judgment upon the land of Mizraim. So the Peshach that we are keeping this day, today, it is a memorial, Israel, that we Zakar to remember of what occurred on the first Peshach. We do not perform this act of the shedding of the blood of beasts.
Yes.
By this matter, because it has been complete in Yahshua HaMashiach by Almighty God. We are celebrating the great victory, Teshua in Yahshua HaMashiach.
Yes.
7 days shall you eat unleavened bread. Even on the first day, you shall put away the leaven out of your homes, out of your dwelling places.
Yes.
Have we put the leaven out in Israel tonight?
Yes.
Have we searched our hearts, Olivia, for that leaven and put it away, put it out? Hallelujah. For whosoever eats the leaven, the old leaven, the unleavened bread, from the first day even unto the last day, the day of completion, the seventh day, that nephesh, that soul, shall be cut off from Israel. Deuteronomy 16, verse 1. Watch. We should watch Israel. How do you watch? When you truly watch, you are patient. And you observe. You observe it. So he says, to watch for and observe the month of Abib, to keep the Peshach unto Yahweh our Abba. That's what we're doing. We're watching, waiting patiently, keeping this Peshach unto Almighty Yahweh. In the month of Abib, your Abba brought you forth out of the land of Mizraim. Has it not brought us forth, Israel?
Yes.
Every day is a bringing forth out of Egypt, out of Mizraim. Every day. Every day is a bringing forth out of Mizraim. Whether it's the Mizraim of your mind, your thoughts, your imaginations, Israel, Yahweh, he brings us out. He brings us out. He said, you shall therefore, Zavach, the Peshach, to Yahweh your Abba, of the flock and of the herd, and in the place where Yahweh shall choose to place his shame, his name there. You shall eat no leavening or leavened bread. You shall eat no leavened bread with it. 7 days shall you eat unleavened bread wherewith?
Yes.
Even the bread of affliction. Did not Yahshua taste or eat of that bread of affliction, Israel? For you come forth out of the land of Mizraim in haste, that you may remember the day when you came forth out of the land of Mizraim.
Yes.
All the days of your life. I will never forget the day I come out of Israel, the deliverance of Almighty Yahweh through the dawn of Yahshua HaMashiach, Yahweh's Peshach.
Yes.
And in the first day there shall be a Kodesh convocation, and in the seventh day there shall be a Kodesh convocation unto you. No matter what shall be done in them, save that which every man must eat.
Yes.
That only may be done of you, Israel. And you shall observe the feast of unleavened bread, for in that same day I have brought your armies out of the land of Mizraim. Therefore shall you observe this day in your generations forever and ever, Israel.
Hallelujah.
Chapter 12, verse 18 of Shema, as we continue, Israel. In the first month, on the 14th day of that month, at evening, you shall eat unleavened bread until the 1 and 12th day of that month, at that evening. 7 days shall there be no leaven found in your houses. So not only have we searched our lives for the leaven, within the 7 day period, Israel, we should not allow leaven into Abayah. Verse 19. 7 days shall there be no leaven found in your bayit. For whosoever eats that which is leaven, we eat of the corrupt leaven, Israel, during these 7 days, even that nessus also shall be cut off from the congregation of Israel.
Yes.
Whether it be a stranger or whether it be one born in the land of Israel.
Yes.
You shall eat nothing leavened. In your habitations shall you eat only unleavened bread. Yes. Now is the instruction unto Israel.
Yes.
How to observe Yahweh's Pesach.
Yes.
Verse 21 of chapter 12, Sima. Then Moshe called for all of the Zakim, the elders of Israel, and said to them, draw out and take you a lamb according to your families.
Yes.
And he says, to kill the Peshach. Was not Yahshua HaMashiach killed for us?
Yes.
Israel.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. So we must draw out the Torah out of our lives, Israel. Yes. Yahshua HaMashiach that dwells in us. And you shall take a bunch of hyssop. Do we understand what the hyssop is for, Israel? The hyssop. The ezel. The hyssop. It's a plant used in bunches for purification. Do we not recall?
Help me,
Dawid cried unto Almighty Yahweh and to Helium. Mm-hmm. Did he not say, purge me with hyssop, Yahweh, and I shall be clean, wash me, I shall be white as snow. Yes. Hallelujah. Do we want Yahweh to purge us with this hyssop?
Yes.
And with the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. Then we become, be white as snow, Israel.
Yes.
With hyssop. And it says, and dip it in the dung that is in the basin. Hallelujah. Isn't that beautiful as we think about that, Israel?
Yes.
This hyssop, this herb, this sweet smelling savor, it's nothing really more than just mint, Israel.
Help me,
it has a sweet smelling savor. That sweet smelling savor unto Almighty Yahweh. Even as Yahshua HaMashiach was smitten on that stake. Hallelujah. Did it not please Yahweh that Yahshua was beaten?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So we see the hyssop, hallelujah, established with the dung.
Yes.
And it says again, and he stand to strike it on the lintel and on the two bolt doorposts. And with the blood that is in the basin, and none of you shall go out of the door of the house until the morning. For Yahweh will pass through and smite Mizraim. And when he sees the dung upon the lintel, the dung of Yahshua HaMashiach, on the two doorposts, Yahweh will pass over the door and will not suffer the destroyer to come into your houses to smite you.
Yes.
For you shall observe this thing and a statute to you and your son, your man, your children, your young men. Hallelujah. Forever. Yes. And it shall come to pass when you come into the land which Yahweh shall give you, according to as he has promised, that you shall keep this service.
Yes, yes.
What is a service or this labor? Have we not labored to prepare ourselves tonight, Israel? Have you not labored, those that are listening by via live stream, for this opportunity? A work, a labor. We have labored here by sweat, by our hands, to prepare for this night, Israel. And it shall come to pass when your babe, your children, shall say to you, what is the meaning of this service? What is the meaning of this act or this work unto Almighty Yahweh that we prepare for this day? Then you shall say, it is the Zalak of Almighty Yahweh.
Yes.
It is Yahweh's Peshach.
Yes.
Yahweh's Peshach.
Yes.
Who passed over the houses of the children of Israel in Mizraim.
Yes.
He smote Mizraim and delivered our houses, and the people bow the head and worship.
Hallelujah.
Let us worship. Let us bow our heads unto Almighty God. And worship Yahweh for what he has done for us, Israel, his face shall. And the children of Israel went away and did as Yahweh had commanded Moshe and Aharon to do, so they did. Hallelujah.
Yes, we must.
Is that not beautiful, Israel?
Yes.
That Yahweh has provided Yahshua HaMashiach, our Pesach.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We didn't have to do anything, Israel.
Yes.
But there's nothing we could have done. It took the dawn. Hallelujah. The precious dawn of Yahshua HaMashiach. And at this time, hallelujah, Israel, we do ask that Ko Yisrael Teshua will come forth, hallelujah, with another song.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, a song of praise. Of the God of Yahshua, HaMashiach. Hallelujah. And after that, we'll have the reading of the covenant by Rabbi David Yisrael. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of the Passover, Yochanan John 2:23. It states now when Yahushua was in Yerushalayim at Pesach, in the feast days, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. Yahushua anointed by Miriam, Yochanan 12:1. Then Yahushua 6 days before the Pesach in Bethany, when Lazarus was, which had been dead, whom he raised from the dead, there made him a supper with Martha served, but Lazarus was one of them that sat at the table with him. Then took Miriam a pound of ointment of spikenard, very costly, and anointed the feet of Yahushua, and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the odor of the ointment. Then said one of his disciples, Yehuda Iscariot, Simeon's son, who should betray him, why was not this ointment sold for 300 pence and given to the poor? This, he said, not that he cared for the poor, but because he was a thief, and had the bag, and bare what was put therein. Then said Yahushua, let her alone against this day of my bearing. Has she kept this? For the poor always you have with you, but me you will not have always. Many of the people, the Yehudim, therefore knew that he was there, and they came not for Yahushua's sake, but only that they might see Lazarus also, whom he had raised from the dead. But the chief Cohen consulted that they might put Eleazar Lazarus to death, because that by reason of him many of the Yehudim were leaving the Kohen and believing on Yahushua. It states in the capture, Yahushua enters into Yerushalayim. On the next day, many of the people that were come early for the Moed, the feast, when they heard Yahushua was coming to Yerushalayim, they took branches of palm and went forth to meet him. And they cried, Hosanna, Barach is the Melech of Yisrael, that come in the name of Yah. Yahushua, when he had found a young ass, he sat upon it, as it was written. He says, fear not, Bath of Zion, behold, your Melech, your king, comes sitting on an ass colt. These things his disciples understood not at the time, but when Yahushua was esteemed, then remember they that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things to him. The people, therefore, that were with him when he called Eleazar out of the grave and raised him from the dead, they bear records. For this cause the people also met him, for that they heard that he had done this miracle. The Pushim, the Pharisees, therefore said among themselves, do you perceive how we prevail nothing? Behold, the entire Olam has gone after him. And now the singing of Teshua community, and after that, Rezachin, Benjamin, Abbas will read the account of Yahushua's death. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know about y'all.
That's so good.
I told y'all.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
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 Yes.
Boy, he loved us so much.
Yes.
And even though he loved us so much, he showed us what a true friend is.
Yes.
He shed his precious donkey.
Yes.
No greater friend than a friend that laid out his life for
us. Hallelujah.
Oh, I'm going to rock him tonight.
Yes.
To
the God.
And tell his speech one more time.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
No other place I would rather be. Yes, right, y'all.
I thought about that. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. Hallelujah.
Yahshua condemned and impaled.
Yes.
And the true Pesach lamb. It said, Yochanan 19:1. Then Pilate therefore took Yahshua and scourged him.
Yes, yes.
Listen, Israel, of what this true and precious one went through for us.
Yes.
We should always be more than total to praise his mighty name.
Yes, yes.
Yes. It said, Yochanan 19:2. And the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head.
Yes.
And they put it on him, a purple robe.
Yes.
We have not been through nothing like this precious one.
Mm-hmm.
It said, Hail, Melech, of the Yehudim. And they smote him with their hands.
Sure they did.
And Pilate therefore went forth again and says to them, Behold, I bring him forth to you.
Yes.
That you may know that I find no fault in him.
That's the truth.
When I stand before Yahshua, I'm sure.
Yes.
I want it to be. He find no fault in me. Yochanan 19:5 say, Then came Yahshua forth, wearing the crown of thorn and the purple robe.
Yes.
Pilate said to him, Behold, the man. Oh, he is truly the man. Yochanan 19:6. When the chief Kohen therefore and officers saw him, they cried out, saying, Impale him, impale him.
Yes.
Pilate said to them, You take him and impale him, for I find no fault in this prayer, without no blemish.
Mm-hmm.
Yochanan 19:7, the Yehudim answered him, We have a Torah. By our Torah, he ought to die, because he made himself the son of Yahweh.
Yes, yes.
Because he was the living Torah. Yochanan 19:8, when Pilate therefore heard these sayings, he said, was even more afraid, and he had a right to be Israel. Yochanan 19:9. And went again unto the judgment hall, and says to Yahshua, Where are you from? From the hour. But Yahshua gave him no answer.
Yes.
Why? Because he was being obedient to the will of Allah.
Yes.
Yahweh.
Yes.
For you, Israel,
yes.
He knew that he had to go through. That we will be made in a special people elected by Baba Yahweh.
Yes, yes.
I told y'all
yes,
that they was
yes.
one that didn't back down.
Yes.
But stood the test.
Yes.
Israel.
Yes.
Yochanan 19:10. Then said Pilate to him, You speak not to me. Don't you know that I have power to impale you and have power to release you?
Yes.
And neither did he know that he was talking to the one with power.
Yes.
Yochanan 19:11. Yahshua answered, You could have no power at all against me.
Yes.
Except
yes.
it was given to you from above.
Yes, from above.
Therefore that delivered me to you have the greatest sin.
Mm-hmm.
Yochanan 19:12 said, And from that time on Pilate sought to release him. But the Yehudim cried out, saying, If you let this man go, you are not Caesar's friend. Whosoever makes himself a king speaks against Caesar.
Yes.
And Yochanan 19:13 said, When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he brought Yahshua forth and sat down in the judgment seat in the place that is called the pavement, but in the Hebrew, Gabbatha.
Yes.
Yochanan 19:14. And it was the preparation of the Pesach.
Hallelujah.
And about the sixth hour, he said to the Yehudim, Behold your Melech, in Yokohama 19 and 15, but they cried out, away with him, away with him. And impale him, Pilate says to them. Shall I impale you, my light? The chief Kohen answered, and we have no king but Caesar.
Yes.
Told y'all that they said away with him because of that precious blood.
Yes.
He made us a special people in his elect, a people that he truly loved. In Yokohama 19 and 16, then Pilate delivered him to them to be impaled, and they took Yeshua and led him away. In Yokohama 19 and 17, and he burned his stake, hallelujah, totally out for the stake, and went forth into a place called the place of a skull, which is called in the Hebrew name Golgotha. And Yokohama 19 18 says, where they impaled him and two others with him, on either side one, and Yeshua in the midst.
Yes.
And Israel, he's in the midst tonight, Israel. Yes. On his face, Shaq. Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. At this time, we do ask that Art Shimmery, hallelujah, if you would come up, my precious Art.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Todiyah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeshua owned that precious stake. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. The reading by our precious Ark Shimri. Hallelujah.
Shimri. Yes.
So let you Todiyah. Yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That Yah went upon the stake for us.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That we as the people of Yah.
Yes.
May have a chance to inherit the kingdom of Yah.
Yes.
Are we as a people of Yah?
Yes.
Are we ready?
Yes.
Are we preparing our hearts?
Yes.
Are we allowing Yah to deal with us?
Yes. Deal with me, Yah.
That we may be a people.
No doubt about it.
That are ready to go upon this stake of Yah, to endure this stake of Yah, to endure these sufferings, because this is of Yah, as a people.
So true.
Are we allowing Yah to prepare our minds?
Yes, prepare
our lives.
Yeah.
For you look at the world today, they celebrate their holidays and their Christmases and their Easters and
pagan
and all of those pagan things. But do we as a people of Yah?
Yes.
Do we take Yah's feast days of that importance?
Yes.
And we should as the people of Yah.
Sure,
those of us that are a little older, we have celebrated Christmas and those holidays, and we were very excited.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We were very excited.
Yes.
We can recall those days. I know I can.
Yes, I
the excitement.
Yes.
So let us get this of Yah. Let us have that same excitement.
Hallelujah.
For this occasion. Unto Yah.
Hallelujah.
And when he brought us out.
Hallelujah.
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 He brought us out. He's given us a chance.
Yes.
He has us in a set and appointed place that we may celebrate his day.
Yes, he does.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And as I read here, Yeshua on the stake.
Yes.
Yokohama 19:19. And Pilate wrote a title.
Yes.
And put it on the stake. And the writing was Yeshua of Nazareth, the king of the Yahudim. Yokohama 19 and 20.
Yes.
This sign then read many of the Yahudim. For the place where Yeshua was impaled was nigh to the city. And it was written in Hebrew and Greek and Latin.
Yes.
Yokohama 19:21. Then said the chief Kohen of the Yahudim to Pilate, right now, the king of Yahudim, but that he said, I am Melech of the Yahudim.
Yes.
And Pilate answered, what have I written? What I have written, I have written.
Yes, yes.
Then the soldiers, when they had impaled Yeshua, took his garments and made four parts, to every soldier a part, and also his coat.
Sure they did.
Now the coat was without seam, woven from the top throughout.
Yochanan 19:24. They said therefore among themselves, let us not tear it.
Yes.
But cast lots for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, they parted my raiment among them. And for my vesture, they did cast lots.
Sure they did.
These things, therefore, these soldiers did.
Sure.
Now, there stood by the stake of Yeshua, his Ema.
Yes.
And his Ema's sister.
Yes.
Miriam, the wife of Cleophas.
Yes.
And Miriam, a Magdalene.
Sure, yeah.
Yochanan 19:26. When Yeshua was therefore saw his Ema and the disciple standing by, whom he loved.
Yes.
He says to his Ema, woman.
Ah.
Behold.
That's what he said.
Your son.
Todayah. Hallelujah.
Then he said to the disciple, behold, your Ema.
Your Ema, yes.
And from that hour, that disciple took her to his own home. Yochanan 19:28. After this, Yeshua, knowing that all things are now accomplished,
all accomplished,
that the scriptures might be fulfilled, say I thirst.
Yes.
Yochanan 19:29. Now therefore was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled the sponge with vinegar, and put it upon hyssop, and put it in his mouth. And when Yeshua therefore had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished.
It is finished. Hallelujah.
It is finished, because this is of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do we not want to make it to this point?
Yes.
That we may be as Yeshua, that we can say, it is finished.
It's finished.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That we may say, it is finished.
Oh, yes.
Do we hear what the word of Yah is saying here? It is finished.
It's finished.
Do we not want to make it to that point?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
That we may be, as our example here is showing us, that it is finished. So let us get this about. Let us endure.
Yeah.
Let us tell the Yah that we have made it unto another paycheck.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Another year that we have made it through.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That we may endure this race.
Yes, we shall.
As tough soldiers.
Yes.
Unto Yah. That we may get to this point. Yes. That we bear this cross as the people of Yah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Regardless of what our kinsmen do. Hallelujah. Regardless of what we have to suffer. Regardless of what we go through.
Yes.
Let us stand as the people of Yah.
Yes.
Oxen and a coatees unto Yah.
Yes.
That we'll hover one the other.
Yes.
With a true heart.
Yes.
Hallelujah, with a true mind of Yahshua HaMashiach.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That we may be an example unto our little ones.
Yes.
That they may follow our patterns.
Yes.
And if some of the old ones may pass on, then the little ones may carry this thing on until Yahshua HaMashiach comes.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So let us stand strong in this one, y'all.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That we may get to this point. That we may, and it says, it is finished. And he bowed his head.
Abba.
And it says what? And he gave up the Ruach.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let us strive for this of Yah. That we may get to this point. That we as the people of Yah.
Yes.
That are grounded and rooted in Yah's truth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That we may give up this Ruach.
Yeah.
That we may reign with Yah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. At this time, do ask the Ruach that we.
Hallelujah. It's so blessed. Filled with the delight of Yah as we come near the time of the Pesach meal, as we gather here.
You that have joined us,
we're going to gather and consume the delicacies that Yah has granted unto us. But I shall read as our Akshimri, what a great blessing that and inspiration. Yeah. The bosom of Yisrael, as we continue to fight the battle, even our circumstances, the great afflictions that we endure in our bodies, yet we know that Yah sustains us, and what a testimony of gravity and great strength unto all of us.
Hallelujah.
Not only his words are words, but his example before us speaks great volume.
Hallelujah.
That it caused tears in my heart that to see his strength. I do barak Yah for that. I did not intend to have me, I intended to go over this before we had it printed, because I didn't intend to read much, all right? Everything in your hands. You will believe next year will not be like this, all right? It says here, Pilate says to the Yehudim a description of each of us that Yeshua has released us from all of our sins. John 18:39. He said unto Yeshua, but you have a custom that I should release to you one prisoner on the Pesach. And we are that one that have been released. Yeshua has released us all. Who will you therefore that I release to you? The Melach of the Yehudim, and they cried again, saying, not this man, but Barabbas. Now Barabbas was a robber. Yeshua appears to the other disciples after his resurrection, as all Israel shall be resurrected. In the book of Lucas, the writing, Mark of Lucas, Luke 24:44. Yeshua said to them, these are the words which I spoke to you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which are written in the Torah of Moshe, and in the Navi, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then he opened their understanding, that they might understand Chitvei HaChodash, that they could understand Scripture. And he said to them, so it is written, so it was necessary that HaMashiach suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and the remission of sin should be proclaimed, preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Yerushalayim. This is a simple description of the Pesach meal as we go to prepare for that as for this occasion.
Hallelujah.
The description of the Pesach process by Yah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I really don't feel like reading that. I'm going to submit to Zakein Darabia and have him to read the Pesach meal. And then Zakein that we will rock the blessing of the food we shall eat. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Israel. Hallelujah.
Ah, yes.
A brief subscription of the Pesach meal.
Yes.
And they shall eat the flesh in that night, roast with fire, and that's what we have done, yes. Israel. And unleavened bread, we have the unleavened bread.
Yes.
And with the bitter herbs, they shall eat it.
Yes.
It is not raw, nor boiled, nor with water, but roasted with fire.
Yes.
His head with his legs, and we have the heads, even Israel.
Yes.
And the inward parts.
Sure.
And you shall let nothing of it remain until the morning. And that which remain of it until the morning, you shall burn it with fire.
Yes.
And this shall you eat it with your loins girdle, your shoes on your feet. Yes. We have our shoes on, Israel.
Yes.
And your staff, the staff, hallelujah.
Yes.
The comforting of Almighty Yahweh.
Yes.
And you shall eat of it in haste. It is Yahweh's Pesach. Hallelujah, yes. Yahweh. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Just a few verses here. I'm going to, so we can move on through this Israel. Hallelujah. Yes. Into the meal, this Pesach. Ephesians 6:10. Finally, my ark, we must be strong in Yeshua and in the manifestation of his power and his strength.
Yes.
Putting on the whole armor of Almighty Yahweh, yes, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of HaSatan.
Mm-hmm.
For we know that we wrestle not against flesh, not against blood, but against principalities and the powers, against the rulers of darkness in high places of this world.
Yes.
Against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take you on the whole armor. Let's have the whole armor.
Yes.
That you may be able to withstand in the evil day, having to do all, Yisrael.
Yes.
We must stand. Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. We must stand, Yisrael.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us stand to our feet.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
As we barak this meal, Yah's Pesach, Yisrael.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Abba Yahweh, come on, son.
Hallelujah.
Abba Yahweh has done so much for us, Israel.
Yeah.
Sure.
Hallelujah.
Ah, yes. Ah, yes.
Abba Yahweh.
Yes.
In the name of Yahshua, HaMashiach.
Yes.
We're going to thank you for the paycheck.
Yes,
all the gathering
yes.
here.
yes.
For everyone that come here this evening, Yahweh, that yes. we enjoy your paycheck.
Yes.
That we must learn to love one another.
Yes, yes.
And we must come to the knowledge that you are in control of every situation.
Yes.
That we must trust you in all things. Yes. It's impossible to please you without faith, Yahweh. That we need that faith to endure till the end. Thank you for the food we're about
yes.
to receive.
Yes, Todah.
Thank you for the paycheck.
Yes.
For the meal that we
yes.
receive, yes. Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Can we give a shout out of the meal before they start eating? We want you all
yes.
that join us and you that desire to be with us and could not, but yet you're with us.
Hallelujah.
It's such a wonderful power today. We have labored our precious support. Let's just give them a hand for their labor.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You do not laugh at the labor. It's just a preparation. And so we have an abundance of display of the abundance of Yah's blessings here in Teshuvah community. And we want our Simeon, our precious up, to give you just a pat on the view as we shall endure all of these wonderful delicacies as Yisrael come to enjoy. Stay with us, Yisrael. We're going to be here for some time as we enter into the Matzvah of Yah, the unleavened bread, as the sun here and the Teshuvah community is going down, and we will take a partake of the Yavarat. Come on, Ma'ak Simeon. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ah, they have the goat's head. Ah, all the meat cooked off.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
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 Ah, yes, the ram's head. All the wonderful food. Let's have a wonderful time in Israel. Hallelujah. Gathered at Teshuvah some of the finest of delicacies as arachot. They have labored to make sure we had a wonderful meal. I hope that you that have joined us, that all has gone very well with you all. We're going to proceed into the next aspect of this Pesach, which is vitally important, one of the most important things. And our Zachin Yeramiah and I will conduct this process. But at this time, we're going to have our precious voices to come, to show voices, led by our Ach Yosefia, to come and sing. Come on, and sing us a song, and then we're going to go into the foot washing, as the old ones would say, the foot washing service, all right? So come on with a beautiful song, and give us something as we're rejoicing. Hallelujah. We greet you all that have joined us this live event tonight. Your intention, may the riches of God rest upon you all. May He fill your land with great riches and blessings. All right, Teshua, come on. Hallelujah. You all got a lot of pretty songs. Sing it. Is the power on?
It's volume on the keyboard.
Keyboard.
Hallelujah.
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 Yeah.
even know if I can operate any farther, but that's all right. I'll tell you, I am full. Hallelujah. But this is a great event that we will proceed into here, the foot washing service. It is the beauty of humility that God grants only to the heart of Yisrael, and those that are offended by even this process, but we are not offended by Yisrael.
Hallelujah.
It's a sign of humility to humble ourselves and to esteem one greater than our own selves. We began here, our Zakir and I want to read. Is this for me to read? Hallelujah. Here in Marcus Hamashiach, as he instituted the supper and the foot washing service. Hallelujah. It says in Marcus 14:22, and as they did eat, Joshua, he took bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to them and said, take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup and what he had given to Dab, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, this is my dam of the renewed covenant, of the Brit Hadassah, which is shed for many. Truly I say to you, I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day that I drink it new in the Melchut of Almighty Yah. And it speaks here in verse 25, when he consummate the marriage with his bride Yisrael. And when they had sung a song of praise, they went out into the Mount of Olives. Joshua said to them, oh, you shall be offended because of me this night. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall be scattered. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do we want to sing? You all ready to sing another song or what? Okay, come on. And then what we're going to do, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We will have the foot washing service. I thought I had some text in here for the reason that we do this. Okay. Yeah, we'll read this. All right. Zakin and I will read this, and then we will perform the foot washing service. All right. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Come on and sing Yisrael.
Yeah.
All right. Hallelujah. Zakin and read. I will read this and you perform the service.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Yeah.
multiplicity of songs like that cause my heart to weep the tears of gladness. As we that are getting older, we know that the promises of His Torah is the only valuable substance we possess. We know that without His promises, and without that comforter, as we get older, then what do we have? The riches of silver and gold will not satisfy us. So the precious diamond and the promise of God. We want to again greet you all. We're going to proceed into the foot washing service. There are some things that Zakane and I will read, hallelujah, in this process. Hallelujah. On page 19, it says, foot washing service after the meal conducted by Zakane, the Ramayah Yisrayam. And Torah reason for why we wash the feet of Yisrael, as Yahushua did his Talmud, his disciples. So we began here in the book of Bereshit, as Yah appears unto Abraham, Genesis 18:1. It says, and Yah appeared unto Abraham in the plains of Mamre, and Abraham sat in the tent door in the heat of the day. When Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and he see three men stood by him. And when he saw them, he ran to meet them from the tent door and bowed himself toward the ground. And Abraham said, Yah, if now I have found favor in your sight, pass not away. I pray to you from your servant. Let a little water, I pray you, be fetched and wash your feet. And rest yourself under the tree. And I will fetch a morsel of bread and comfort you, your levim. After that, you shall pass on, for therefore are you come to your abbot. And they said, so do as you have said. Even Abraham, he saw the beauty of the foot washing of the messengers. We all have the same message. And that is the testimony of Yahushua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It says in Bereshit chapter 19, verse 1, the destruction of Sodom and the deliverance of Lot. And there came two Melechim to Sodom at evening, and Lot sat at the gate of Sodom. And Lot, seeing them, rose up to meet them, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground. And he said, behold, now my master, turn in, I pray you, into your servant's house, and tarry all night, and wash your feet. You shall rise early and go on your way. And they said, nay, we will abide in the streets all night. And he pressed upon them greatly, and they turned in unto him, and entered into his house. And he did make a feast, and baked unleavened bread, and they did eat. I see there's an indication here, probably a form of Pesach. But yet he said, come in and wash your feet. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yahushua has washed the feet of true Yisrael. I will read, hallelujah, one more, and then Zakin will take it from the renewed covenant. I'll read this in First Shmuel. The servant of Dawi encounter Abigail before Dawi takes her to be his wife. And Yahushua, as he did it with the Talmudim, the disciples, he washed their feet before they were solidified as his wife. And so when he got out of the grave, he made sure he restored them. It says in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 25, verse 39, when Dawi heard that Nabal was dead, he said, blessed be Yah, that he was pleased the cause of my reproach from the land of Nabal, and has kept his servant from evil. For Yah has turned the evilness of Nabal upon his own head. And David sent and communed with Abigail, and took her to be his wife, as he sent messengers to retrieve her, as Yah has sent Yahushua as the messenger to receive Yisrael. It says, and when the servants of David came to Abigail, to Carmel, they spoke to her, saying, Dawi sent us to you to take you as his wife. And she arose And she bowed herself as we as the assembly of Yisrael, the elect. She bowed herself to the face of the earth and said, behold, let your handmaid be a servant to wash the feet of the servants of my master. So we shall do that because Yah is our master.
Hallelujah.
We shall wash the feet of the servants of our master. And this act that's carried out, Zacchaeus will take that in the book of Lucas and read that, and we will go forth in the footprints.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The beauty of the acts of great humility, the feet washing, and this account of this woman represents the nation of Israel washing the feet of Yahshua.
Yes.
We are the body of HaMessiah, and we must do the same.
Yes.
Israel.
Yes.
Not only do we wash the feet, but kiss the feet.
Yes.
As this woman did. Luke chapter 7, verse 37. And behold, a woman in the city, which was a sinner,
yes, me.
When she knew that Yahshua sat at meat at the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster box of ointment and stood at his feet behind him weeping and began to wash his feet with her tears and did wipe them with the hairs of her head and kissed his feet and anointed them with the ointment. Now when the Pharisees which had bidden him saw it, he spake within himself, saying, this man, if he were a Nabi, he would have known who and what manner of woman this is that touches him, for she is a sinner. And Yahshua answered and said to him, Simeon, I have something to say to you. And he said, Master, say it. There was a certain creditor which had two debtors, and the one owed 500 pence and the other 50. And when they had nothing to pay, he frankly forgave them both. Tell me, therefore, which of them will love him or hover him the most? Simeon answered and said, I suppose that he to whom he forgave most. And Yahshua said to him, you have rightly judged. And Yahshua turned to the woman and said to Simeon, see you this woman? This is Yisrael. I entered into your house, and you gave me no water for my feet. But she has washed my feet with her tears. Let us wash the feet of Yahshua HaMashiach with our tears, Yisrael, and wipe them with the hairs of her head. You gave me no kiss, but this woman, since the time I have came in, has not ceased to kiss my feet.
Yes.
Don't you see the humility in this act, Yisrael? Even as we, as this woman, just a sinner, hallelujah, saved by the dom of Yahshua HaMashiach, kissing his feet, so should we do to one another, Yisrael. We will follow the same example of this woman as we are this woman, because Yahweh has forgiven us of many great sins.
Yes.
Told out to Yah, hallelujah, Yahweh. Told out to Yah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yahshua comforts his disciples and washed their feet. This way, this is why we should wash the feet of Yisrael. John chapter 13, verse 1. Now before the feast of Pesach, when Yahshua knew that his hour was come, that he should depart out of this world to the Abba, having loved his own which were in the world, he loved them unto the end.
Yes.
And supper had ended, and Shaitan, having known to put into the heart of Yehuda his Iscariot, Simon's son, the desire to betray him, Yahshua, knowing that the Abba had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from Yahweh and was going to Yahweh, he arose from the supper and laid aside his garments and took a towel and girded himself. After that, he pours water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was girded. We had came to Simon Kephar, and Kephar saying to him, Yahshua, Master, do you wash my feet? Yahshua answered and said to him, what I do
You do not understand now, but you shall know after this.
Yes, yes.
Kepha says to him, you shall never wash my feet. Yahshua answered him, if I wash not your feet, you have no part with me. Simeon Kepha says to him, Yahshua, not my feet only, but also my hands, my head. Yahshua says to him, he that is bathed needs not to wash except his feet, but is clean already, and you are clean, but not all.
Yes, help me, y'all.
Verse 11, for he knew who should betray him, therefore he said, you are not all clean.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
So let us,
I want you, let us, for this foot washing service as we began, I want precious Akhmikaya, he's been faithful all these years. I know we always honor the Zaki, but I want him to come, Zaki Yaramiya, he wash his feet, and I want my friend Zaki Shimri to come, and I will wash his feet as we start this service.
Yabra.
Hallelujah. Come on, Yisrael, your courts, Rafael, yours down here. Make sure we get all of this by Simeon so that others receive and see the beauty of God, the foot washing service. It's one of the most beautiful events. Can you play something to Sissy Yah while we? What a beautiful occasion this is. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. My son came. I'm going to wash your feet, my friend. Come on, you say that's all right. Hallelujah. All right. Hallelujah. Yes, beautiful. Yes. Hallelujah. Let me take them shoes off. Yes, both of them. You know how much of your mics? Kissed his feet. Hallelujah. Servant of God, by his anointing.
blessings of God.
Hallelujah.
Needs repentance. Hallelujah. That's all right. No formalism or no ritualism. Just
Hallelujah.
The beauty of his simple command.
Yes.
You wash the feet of one another.
Hallelujah.
What a beautiful blessing that is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Ah, yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Someone of Simeon, he needs to wash someone's feet. Okay, you all got each other. All right, here. Mercy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, the old Kedushim did it this way. You that have joined us, we do pray and hope that as you see this humble act,
Hallelujah.
You can do it in your homes with one another, your children, your ish, your ish. Okay. All right. Hallelujah. Joshua washed the feet of his disciples, then who are we? We should not wash the feet of his disciples. We are the disciples of Yah and Yahshua. Hallelujah. What a beautiful thing it is. Hallelujah. Ah, sing Israel. We sing to Yah for his great riches and his blessings. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ah, yes. Ah, the blessings of Yah. We teach our young ones the ways of Yah. They may learn and sustain themselves. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You know what? Just speak with some oil. You put some oil on that. Oh. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. Hallelujah. 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 Ah, yes. Hallelujah. Beauty of Yisrael. Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Put the camera on this Obsidian. Our precious friend here. Our brother. Zephaniah. Blessings of Yah. You can wash his feet. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Great blessing, Yisrael. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Ah, yes, he is our healer.
Hallelujah.
He is our Rapha. He is able, above all things, to heal this nation and his people by his healing hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can roll the little pants down, they'll be all right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ah, yes. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. Hallelujah. Beautiful Zaki. Ah, the blessings of Yah leads us. Ah, yes. Hallelujah. 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 Ah, yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Great blessings of Yah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Praises to God. Hallelujah. There are no praises that are any higher. Lift your hands. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's been so wonderful to us. What a great blessing.
Hallelujah. 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 What a beautiful occasion.
Yes.
What a beautiful act of humility that we show our Abba, one of the pillars of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. We have another song up.
Actually, yes.
Let's have another song. Hallelujah. 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 Bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. strength. Yahshua HaMashiach, the Lamb. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As we continue, Israel, as we bring all things to an end here.
Hallelujah.
We want to talk about the communion of the body of Yahshua. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So Saul reminds them of the nature of the design of Peshach institution.
Yes, he did.
1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. For I have received of Yahshua that which also I deliver unto you, that the master Yahshua, the same night in which he took bread, and when he had took, and when he had given todah, he brake it, and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, this do you in remembrance of me. After the same manner, he also took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this cup is a brit hadassah in my dam.
Yes.
This do you as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. He wants us to zakah to remember him, Israel.
Yes, sure.
For as often as you eat this lashon, as often as we eat it, and drink this cup, you do show Yahshua HaMashiach's death until he come, Israel.
Yes.
So in this, it's not an act of just an act, just we just do it, Israel. We do it in remembrance of Yahshua HaMashiach.
Yes.
All he has done for us, how he stood the test.
Yes.
The word stood the test. Even on the stake, it stood the test. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So must we, Israel, also stand the test. Hallelujah.
Yes.
To the Yahweh. As we make preparation, Israel, for this, okay, hallelujah.
Yes, come on.
Come on, hallelujah. Let's get the body and the dawn, hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Let's do that.
Hallelujah. As often as we do this, Israel,
yes,
let us remember.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Sometimes we have to go back, Israel, and see where Yahweh has brought us from. As the old tradition would say, he has brought us from a mighty long way. Hallelujah. And even still yet, we have a ways to go, Yisrael. But just as Yahweh, he is the author, he's the beginner of all things, he also ends all things. There's nothing he starts. There's nothing he begins that he don't finish.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. All things he begins, he finishes, Yisrael. So don't doubt, let us be patient, hallelujah, and allow the Torah, the Mitzvah, the Ruach of Almighty Yahweh have its way in us, hallelujah, to make us, to mold us, into his image, into what he wants us to be, not the American dream, be all you can be. You got those that try to be all they can be, what are they? Nothing. Those that they have possessions, they have nothing without Yahshua HaMashiach. We can say today and definitely, Israel, that we have Yahshua.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we have Yahshua, we have no need of anything else. Hallelujah. He shall provide all that we need. So as we partake tonight, Israel, let us search our lab. Hallelujah. For the leaven. Hallelujah. Anything that is not of Yahweh. As we claim the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. All the precious done, it cleanses and it washes from all sin. He didn't give us a list of sins. He said it only goes this far, it only take care of that. But the dam covers it all, Yisrael. Hallelujah. We're covered by the dam of Yahshua tonight. Hallelujah. So let's partake of his body. Let's partake of the dam. Hallelujah. To the Yahweh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says here, Israel, and I'm going to read this through this one time before we partake, Israel. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 27. Wherefore, whosoever eat this bread and drink this cup of Yahshua unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the dam of Yahshua. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the lashem and drink that cup.
Yes.
For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eat and drink damnation unto himself, not discerning the body of Yahshua HaMashiach. For in this cause many are weak and are sickly among
yes.
you.
Yes.
And many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of Almighty Yahweh, that we should not be condemned with the world. Hallelujah. That we not be condemned with the world, Israel.
Yes, yes.
Let us take this bitter herb.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
This represents the bitterness of the agony and the pains, Israel, Yahshua yes. HaMashiach. Let us take part of the herb. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Help us, yeah. Help me.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let us hold the bread, Yisrael. For I have received of Yahshua
yeah.
that which also I have delivered unto you, that the Master Yahshua, the
yes.
same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let us partake of the body of Yahshua HaMashiach, the lashem, the bread. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And when he had took, he had given Todah.
Todah.
And he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body,
yes.
which is broken for you. This do you in remembrance
you
of me.
Remember
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Let's partake of the body in remembrance
yes.
of him.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The body of Yahshua HaMashiach.
Yes. Remember that body.
And after the same manner, he also took the cup. Do you have
yes.
the cup, Israel?
Yes.
Let's hold the cup. Hallelujah, way. And when he had took the cup, he has up saying, this is the cup of my brit hadassah, of my dam. This do you as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Yes.
So let us drink the dam of Yahshua in remembrance of him. Hallelujah.
Blessed be the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
To the Yahweh.
To the
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. For as often as you eat this leshem and drink this cup,
oh, yes.
we do this right, Yah.
Yes.
We show
yes.
the death until he comes.
Yes.
We testify, hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
of the death of the Dam of Yahshua HaMashiach.
Yes.
And not only that, this right, Yah, his resurrection.
Yes.
In our bosom.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For was if it had not been for Yahshua,
yes.
this Peshat Lamb, Yahweh's
yes.
offering to Israel, where would we be, Israel?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We do ask that Zalkei Mahalia. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Okay. We told y'all for all things. We told about
yes.
the fellowship.
Yes.
And we told about what he done. And no matter how many here, he said, well, wherever he had a two or three in his name, that he in the midst. So
yes.
we're not
yes.
worrying about number. We're just worrying about that we serve Yahweh and be real with him
yes.
and do things pleasing to him.
Yes.
That's all that matters. So
sure
so he in the midst. So all we do is just keep on what we're doing and
yes.
striving with Yahweh
yes.
And trying to do his will and do right. And love each other and
yes.
have fellowship with each other. And I need to work on that myself and
yes,
fellowship with each other. And so we're not worrying about it, no. We had a lovely time
yes.
tonight and we had a wonderful time, plenty to eat. Our belly full. We,
yes.
we ain't got nothing to complain about. We never had to complain about it.
Yeah.
But if
yeah.
we complain about it, we're not grateful for
yeah.
what he do. So
yes.
we told y'all everything. We told y'all for all the sight here, the
yes.
one that here, stayed here, the one that gone.
Yes.
Where know that Yahweh, he know what he done.
Yes.
So all we have to do is just keep on scribing to do right with Yahweh and do things to please him, yes, and not try to please this old flesh. Because when we, yes, do that, we're in the flesh of manifestation, regardless of whatever the situation is. Yes. So we need help. I need help on that,
yes,
on the spiritual situation. And that's all we need to look up. We look up for Yahweh, and that's where our help comes from. And I was jumping, yeah, I was jumping God now. So I told y'all, and I told him for the power, I told him for all the saints, and they pray for me to keep me strong, keep me, yeah, in the will of Yahweh. And I have struggles just like y'all, yeah, the same thing. But still, we can help each other. Yeah. And we need to do that from our lab, not just saying that. We need to do it from our lab. He needs to work on me first. So yes, if they work on me first, then I can help somebody else.
Yeah.
So I told y'all for that. All right. Y'all, we thank you for the fellowship. We thank you for,
yes,
all things. We thank you, yes, that for the rain that he, yes, gave us. We needed, yes, rain, and we thank you for the,
yes,
pool that we had and where, yes, we had, and we baracked it, and we told him for all things. We told, yes, him for that he watching over us tonight when we go, yes, home, that we sleep in our bed, that he wake us up in the morning in our right mind and,
yes,
start us on our way. On our way to do things right and plead for him and have the love for one another like we should, and we need to work on that, and I need to work on that too. So
yes,
we thank Yahweh for that, you know. And we don't need no food for our battle that much. We need his word. We need to put his word.
Yes.
The truth. The truth. We need the truth. But I thank you for that. In the name of Joshua, in the name of Joshua, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.